trustees. Mr. Clark, I see what's the next paper. Let's do number two. Let's see, there's a group of two. Yeah, 4, 5, and 6. Let's go ahead and call this paper and get those papers.
Okay, Mr. Chair, item number two, ordinance number 2012. I'm sorry.
4, 5, and 6.
Item number four, ordinance number 2012-203, to authorize the CAO to execute a master agreement for the use of Commonwealth Transportation Fund between the city and the Virginia Department of Railroad and Public Transportation for the purpose of utilizing grant proceeds from the department. Item number five, ordinance number 2012-204, to authorize the CAO to execute a grant agreement between the city and the Federal Transit Administration for the purpose of receiving federal funding of $10,031,620 for the fund of capital improvements at the Main Street Station. And item number six, ordinance number 2012-205, to authorize the CAO to execute a project agreement for use of Commonwealth Transportation Funds fiscal year 2013 between the city and the Virginia Department of Rail and Public Transportation for the purpose of receiving a grant of $2,507,906 to fund the rehabilitation and renovation of Main Street Station and associated architectural and engineering activities.
Good evening. My name is Victoria Basher. I'm with the Department of Community and Economic Development. These are companion papers to papers you've already seen before on authorizing the CAO to enter into the agreements with the Virginia Department of Rail and Public Transportation. This is about $12.5 million of funding that will go to phase three, which will be at the beginning of next year. The third paper is the standard agreement that we have with the Virginia Department of Rail and Public Transportation that we do meet.
Any questions for Ms. Badger? Seeing none, okay, let's open up the public comment. Have anybody speak in favor of this paper? Or opposed? Seeing none, I'll bring it back to the committee.
Move to Board of Council for approval.
Okay. I'll second that. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, Mr. Clark, let's do paper number 9.
Yeah, Mr. Chair, before we move on, I understand Ms. Robson has to leave. Can we approve the minutes?
Make a motion to approve.
Good. Yeah. A second.
You have to call the right date. Yeah, two over 16 minutes.
Okay. Thank you.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, Mr. Clark, we'll go to paper 9.
Item number 9, ordinance number 2012-212, to erect always stop signs and all old fashioned red lights at the intersection of North Nansen Street and Kensington Avenue to replace the existing traffic regulations at that intersection.
Good evening, I'm Tom Flint, City Transportation Engineer. We respectfully do not support this paper. We feel that this intersection currently is operating in a very safe and efficient manner. It's had 5 accidents over the last 3 years, or about 1.5 accidents per year, which is below the average for an intersection of this level of activity. The geometrics are good. For example, site distance is good there. And also, it does not meet the federal state guidelines that we adhere to for installation of long-way stop. So we do not support the paper. Having said that, a couple comments. There is a flasher at this intersection, which is old, and we'd be happy to update that with the newer current standards one. And also, if you would allow us, we'd be happy to look at the intersection and see if there's some things that we feel can make it safer other than an all-way stop. Do you have any questions?
Just for the mayor.
Mr. Thomas, not here, I don't see him.
Mr. Flynn, do you happen to know if, petitions? Do you know if there were petitions circulated asking for this, or was this signed up one individual that asked Mr. Tyler?
I know of nothing. The first I heard of this was when it showed up on the chat.
Mr. Singh?
Yes.
We do know that one of the city associations had requested that there be an installation of some signs.
The museum district association had requested this installation.
Right, not a petition for the district association. That's what it's pertaining to.
Thank you.
Okay, let's open this up to public comment. Do you have any people here who speak in support of this paper or in opposition?
My name is Silver Persinger. I'm a citizen of Richmond, Virginia. I would like to speak in opposition to this paper. This paper is news to me, but based on Mr. Flynn's comments, I think it's very prudent to keep the flashing lights there. I appreciate his offer to update the lights and to look at the intersection to see if there are any further improvements to make. I would like to recommend that the committee recommend to strike this paper. Thank you for the opportunity to comment.
Thank you. No further comments. I'll bring it back to the committee. What are our thoughts? In this paper, I don't know whether that be very pointless or exactly what.
I think I know exactly where this is. This is an intersection where a lot of people get confused and come to a stop anyway. There's only one yellow box hanging kind of in the middle of the intersection that flashes. Nobody knows if that's to alert them to a stop sign or not. East-west traffic doesn't have a stop sign. North-south traffic does. I use this road on a regular basis. I've seen a lot of confusion by a lot of people at this. If the museum district is supporting this, those are the people that have to live with it day in and day out. I'd make a motion to forward it to council for approval. And if something comes up in the meantime and makes a change of mind, so be it.
Now, if you want to make that a motion,
I'll make that a motion.
Okay, I'll second that motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, let's see the next. The next paper we've got here is the paper number three, I guess. Yeah. Paper number three. Thanks.
Mr. Chairman, three, ordinance number 2012-201, to amend the city code for the purpose of encouraging the use of green roofs as defined by the Virginia code by providing for the processing of building permit applications within 10 business days and associated plumbing, electrical, and mechanical permit applications within 5 business days.
Okay, thank you.
Good evening. I'm Alicia Zapoff. I'm the sustainability manager for the city. This ordinance request is actually co-patroned by Mr. Samuels and Mr. Hilbert along with Mayor Jones, and it is to request a ordinance pursuant to Virginia Code, which allows a locality to enact an ordinance of this type to incentivize green roofs, which are defined by the Virginia Code as roofs that are solar, have solar panels, solar roofs, and also vegetative roofs, which we usually think of it as a green roof. And so what this ordinance will do, if enacted, will allow contractors or other folks that want to put a green roof on either a new building, new facility, or an existing facility to do so under a streamlined process to receive the building permit and other related permits that go along with that roof project. And that's simply what it is. So this is in line with the RVA Green Sustainability Plan that Council unanimously adopted back in July. It's one of the initiatives that we're trying to support is to encourage this type of activity in the city. And I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Okay, yeah, no questions. Any public comment? Some people here might speak in support of this paper.
Silver Persinger, I would like to speak in support of this paper and support green roofs. She She said something about incentive. I don't know if that's economic or just merely streamlining the permit process. I'll have to look more into it before the next council meeting, but I'm supportive of streamlining and making the permitting process as quick as possible. Thank you.
Anybody here in opposition to this paper? Seeing none, I'll bring it back to the committee.
Take the motion for it, Nelson Kroger, and I'll second it. All in favor, say
aye. Aye.
Ms. Vaccaro. Okay, I see the, paper number two. Move it back to
that. Mr. Chair, item number two, ordinance number 2012-R149. To express opposition to the proposed Virginia Department of Transportation plan to toll Interstate 95, request the Virginia Department of Transportation to develop a plan to meet the transportation needs of Virginia without tolling Interstate 95, and urge the Commonwealth of Virginia to bring together all affected businesses, industry, and local government to develop a plan to improve Interstate 95.
If my opinion, you said resolution, I'm not ordinance. Just sort of may want to read that into the records to make sure you.
Yes.
And we did say resolution.
Yes.
So that is correct. That's been paperwork wrong. Okay. We have somebody to present this paper. This is pretty.
Mr. Chair. This was meant to be introduced a while back. Some issues came up. We had to address. So we're introducing it now. I'm hopeful that Senator Watkins' plan is kind of putting the death knell on the plan to toll 95, but I would like the city to go on the record as being opposed to a toll on 95, and that's exactly what this resolution does, no more, no less. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you, James. Do we have a little bit of a public comment? Are there people here that would like to support this paper, or are there folks here in opposition to this paper? Seeing none, I'll bring it back to the council.
Motion to forward to council for approval.
I'll second it. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. That paper moves forward. Okay, let's see. We've got number 10. I think that then we already decided to move that to the recommendation. Council, or do we want
to? I don't believe we took a vote.
We have not introduced it yet.
Okay, go ahead. Number 10.
Mr. Chair, item number 10, resolution number 2012 is a correction, resolution number 2012-R143, to declare surplus and to authorize the CAO to seek bids for the property located at 5800 Patterson Avenue, known generally as the West Hampton School.
Okay. Do we have somebody here to present this paper?
This is Mr. Tyler's.
Yeah. It looks like to me this paper is trying to have us back out of the Redskins, and we've got a lot of things up here on Redskins, and I'm not prepared myself. Well, let's open up the public. There are people here today in support of this paper and are people in opposition.
I would like to support Mr. Teller's proposed paper to ask the CAO to, seek bid for the property. As I said earlier, I'm opposed to bringing the Redskins here. I'm supportive of bond supports even using the building. But as I neglected to say in my earlier comment, I am interested in them paying something like a fair market rent for the lease of 60 years, as you proposed. Also support a shorter lease. But, why not? Why not investigate the options, If you don't investigate options, it looks like you've already made up your decision, already made your decision, which I think you all have. If you forward this to council with no recommendation, that's fine. Thank you for the opportunity to comment.
Thank you. Okay, seeing the others, I'll bring it back to the office. I suggest we do it on no recommendation. I'm not supportive of this.
Well, without Mr. Tyler here, I'd love to do anything one way. not go forward, this can always go forward to move the West Hampton School off of our, back onto the tax rolls, whether or not the school stands with this completely up in the air, but whoever buys it can just tear down the school. So I'm a little worried about this. Additionally, an old historic building, the same architect that did Fox Elementary, you know, Park Elementary, worked with another architect to create the Landmark Theater. I'm very nervous about moving forward a paper that doesn't put any controls over the preservation of the building.
You want to do it on the council with that recommendation?
What I'd like to do is continue it until we get Mr. Connick to explain what he wants.
We can certainly do that.
But on the flip side, he's got limited time, so I want to make sure that as he can say, he gets a chance to say it. I'll follow your motion, whatever.
Okay. So we'll move this on the council with no recommendation.
I'll say.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, that's what we'll do. Okay, before I forget about it, we've got presentation, we have two presentations to go, and we'll be finished, but one thing I'd like to mention, it's possible to get forgotten, we had an appointment on the Urban Design Committee, a fellow named Chris Harris, and this fellow recommended to us in the Urban Design Committee itself. So, what are your thoughts on that? I'm pretty cool with that. Well, we could, you know, we could continue this to the next
person. I see Hampton Carver is not available for reappointment. They're recommending that he take that place. Are these other applications for that same position?
Yes, those other applications were for the citizen at large representative. What they do is screen, the Urban Design Committee screens the applications, and then they send a letter recommending someone to take that position. They also have another vacancy coming up for February of next year. We still do the same process. All the applicants you see listed will stay on your list, and I think they already may have someone off this list that they want to fill the position in February.
Housing and Urban Development Requirements for Section